Day 9 for
Andy here. Day 9 for the spoilers of Kaldheim. A lot of good and powerful cards have been already spoiled for this gold set, and more will follow. But before starting, let me show you Battle Mammoth. This was the first card that have been leaked with the Foretell ability. I also used it for my tutorial video. Now it's officially spoiled. Let's start. Master Scald, 4 and 1 white, it's a 4-4, enters the battlefield, you may exile a creature card from your graveyard. If you do, return target artifact or enchantment card from your graveyard to your hand. Ashgard Braga, 3 and 1 white, it's a 3-3, boast, 1 and 1 white, untap it, put a +1/+1 counter on it. Goldmaw Champion, 2 and 1 white, it's a 2-3, boast, 1 and 1 white, tap target creature. Disdainful Stroke, 1 and 1 blue, it's an instant counter target spell with converted mana cost 4 or greater. Volt Robber, 1 and 1 red, it's a 1-3. For 1, tap, exile a creature card from your graveyard, create a treasure token. Grizzled Rider, 4 and 1 green, it's a vanilla creature, 5-5. Ravenous Lindworm, 4 and 2 green, it's a 6-6, enters the battlefield, you gain 4 life. Arachno Form, 1 and 1 green, enchanted creature gets +2/+2, and has reach and this every creature type. Scrown Effigy, 3. 2-3, Foretell, 0. Return Upon the Tide, 4 and 1 black. Return target creature card from your graveyard to the battlefield. If it's an elf, create 2 1-1 green elf warrior creature tokens. Foretell, 3 and 1 black. Doomscar Titan, 4 and 2 red. It's a 4-4. Enters the battlefield, creatures you control get +1/+0 and gain haste until end of turn. Foretell, 4 and 1 red. Dwarf Hammer, 2 and 1 red, equipment, enters the battlefield, you may pay 2 generic mana. If you do, you create a 2-1 red dwarf berserker creature token, then attach the hammer to it. Equip creature gets +3/+0 and has trample. Equip 3. Fearless Liberator, 1 and 1 red, it's a 2-1, boast for 2 and 1 red, create a 2-1 red dwarf berserker creature token. Lijara Glade Warden, 3 and 1 green, it's a 3-3, changeling, 2 and 1 green and tap, exile a creature card from your graveyard, put a 2/+1/+1 counters on target creature, activate this ability only anytime you could cast a sorcery. Finn the Fang Bearer, for 1 and 1 green, it's a 1-3 legendary creature human warrior, death touch, whenever a creature you control with death touch deals combat damage to a player, that player gets 2 poison counters. It seems that poison counters have returned in Kaldheim. We have Vorinclex, a Phyrexian creature. Now we have this particular legendary creature, Finn the Fangbearer, Death Touch. And if any creature that has Death Touch, including Finn, deals combat damage to a player, that player gets 2 poison counters. And when the poison counters are 10, that player loses the game. Arnie Slays the Troll, for 1 red and 1 green, it's Enchantment Saga. Chapter 1, target creature control fights up to 1 target creature you don't control. Chapter 2, add 1 red. Put 2/+1/+1 counters on up to 1 target creature control. Chapter 3, you gain life equal to the greatest power among creatures you control. Nico Defies Destiny, 1 white and 1 blue, another enchantment saga. You gain 2 life for each foretold card you own in exile. Chapter 2, add 1 white and 1 blue, spend this mana only to foretell cards or cast spells that have foretell. Chapter 3, return target card from with foretell from the graveyard to your hand. Ascent of the Worthy, 1 and 1 white and 1 black, it's an uncommon, it's enchantment saga. I really love the artwork of this card. Chapter 1 and chapter 2, choose a creature you control until your next turn, all damage that would be dealt to creatures you control is dealt to the creature instead. Chapter 3, return target cards from your graveyard to the battlefield with a flying counter on it. The creature is an angel warrior in addition to its other types. Colossal Plow, an artifact vehicle, 2, it's a 6-3, whenever it attacks, add 3 white mana, and you gain 3 life. Until end of turn, you don't lose this mana as steps and phases end. Crew 6. Gates of Isfel, enters the battlefield tapped, tap for 1 white, 2 1 white and 2 blue, sacrifice it, you gain 2 life, and draw 2 cards. Very good land, in my opinion. Lijara Mirror Lake, another land, enters the battlefield tapped, you tap for 1 blue, 2 and 2 green, sacrifice it, Create a token that's a copy of target creature you control, except it enters battlefield with an additional 1/+1/+1 counter on it. Kozima, God of the Voyage. 2 and 1 blue, it's a 2/4. Legendary creature God, it's a rare card. At the beginning of your upkeep, you may exile Kozima. If you do, it gains. Whenever a land enters the battlefield under your control, if it's exiled, you may put a voyage counter on it. If you don't, return Kozima to the battlefield with X+1/+1 counters on it and draw X cards, where X is the number of voyage counters on it. Let's say you play Kozima, you put a land in play, you will exile Kozima and put a voyage counter on it. Then you put another land in play, and then you put another voyage counter on Kozima. If you don't put a voyage counter on Kozima, you put Kozima back in play with a +1/+1 counter and draw X cards, where X is the number of voyage counters. It's a very, very interesting card, in my opinion. All gods in Kaldheim are modal double face cards. Therefore, you can choose to play Kozima, God of the Voyage, or you can choose to play the Omen Keel. For 1 and 1 blue, it's a 3/3 legendary artifact vehicle. Whenever a vehicle you control deals combat damage to a player, the player exiles that many cards from the top of their library. You may play lands from among those cards as long as they remain in exile. Crew for 1. Tundra Fumarole for 1 and 2 red. Snow Sorcery, it's a rare card. Deals 4 damage to target creature or planeswalker. Add colorless mana for each snow mana spent to cast the spell. Until end of turn, you don't lose this mana. Critical Mistake, 2 and 2 black. It's a sorcery. All creatures that aren't of the creature type of your choice get -3/-3 until end of turn. This is a very nice board wipe card for black. Last card in this spoiler, Glorious Protector, 2 and 2 white. It's a 3/4. Angelic Cleric, Flesh, Flying, enters the battlefield. You may exile any number of non-angel creatures you control until it leaves the battlefield. Foretell for 2 and 1 white. It's a nice creature to protect your non-angel creatures. Let's say your non-angel creatures are going to die, maybe a board wipe. Play Glorious Protector for Flesh, maybe with the Foretell. Exile those creatures. Glorious Protector dies, those creatures return to the battlefield. Very, very good card. As I said, this was the last spoiler of today. Tune in to my channel for more spoilers of Kaldheim and anything related to Magic the Gathering and the collectible world.